Okay, I just did a video on how long would it take you to bug out? How long would it take you to get your family out of the city, out of the house? How long would it take you guys to be ready? Well, in this video, I want to include some things I think that everybody should gather while they're trying to do that bug out. Obviously, it's not an ideal situation, but if you gotta go and it's an emergency, for whatever reason, you want to have these items. Water filtration. Now, it can include water filters. Something as simple as this straw setup. You put the water in there and you suck through the straw. There's a filter in place that makes it that pretty much filters out all the bad stuff. Or you could use something like a water purification tablets. One of those small jars are actually designed to, they're actually filled with tablets that are designed to filter the water, get all the bad stuff out. At least most of it, especially the bacterial threats. And other ones sort of designed to make it taste better. But anyway, this water filter system, you put the water inside, here's a filter, when you try to suck up the water, it goes through the filter, and it filters the water for you. There's many different designs, many different companies, do your research, but you should always have some type of water filter. Here's a similar design. You put the water in here, the bad water in there, and wipe it down. Screw this on there. Take this top off. Pop this upward, and then you squeeze the water through there. This is the actual water filter. Emergency food. It could be MREs. It could be canned goods. Some type of emergency food. I recommend freeze-dried foods, but if you're going to go with a freeze-dried option, you might want to also have some water. You're also going to need a means of heating up that water, but you definitely got to have some type of emergency food. Something you can just take on the fly, and something you can prepare easily. Okay, some type of self-defense tool. If you can legally own a firearm, then this will be a really good option. I would try to avoid the really small guns, especially if you don't have a lot of experience shooting pistols. Start off with a full-size gun, or at least go to a range and rent out some guns. And I would start with the bigger guns with the longer barrels. They're just easier to control. You know, the smaller guns may be easier to carry around, but these are easier to actually control when you're actually shooting. It's easier to manage the recoil. Speaking of which, I recommend that you have extra ammunition, but don't just leave the ammunition in boxes. Put the ammunition in boxes, but also put them in ammo cans. Something that you can easily transport. Now, the metal ammo cans are actually kind of heavy, but you can go with a plastic ammo can. They offer a lot of protection. Not as much protection, especially from water, but in an emergency situation, they'll do pretty well. Also, you should get extra magazines and actually load up those magazines. Some people frown upon keeping magazines loaded up, but you know, if it's truly an emergency, you don't want to waste your time trying to load up magazines. You want to have more magazines than you think you need. If you have one pistol, I highly recommend that you have at least 4 magazines for your self-defense pistol. All right, if you have medications and they have special requirements such as refrigeration, make some provisions. Obviously, you want to have a refrigerator for your insulin if you're a diabetic or you have a diabetic in your family. But there are some alternatives. At least keep the medication at a decent temperature until you get to the place you need to go. Just try to think of some provisions. Have a plan before it actually happens. Speaking of provisions, make sure you have extras. If you have a lantern, like I do, that runs off of these batteries, make sure you have extra batteries. Yeah, I wouldn't leave them in the car because, you know, over the winter, or they can get exposed to some pretty extreme temperatures, also in the summer. But if you wear glasses, have an extra pair of glasses in your vehicle already ready to go. Have a means of cleaning your glasses, you know, little things like that. If you rely on flashlights, make sure you have plenty of extra batteries. Understand that although I do use rechargeable batteries, if the grid's down, you're not gonna have the ability to recharge the battery. So you still need traditional batteries. All right, be prepared to deal with injuries, cuts, bruises, things like that. Have some type of first aid with some type of tourniquet system or you can use a number of things as a tourniquet, but have a pretty good first aid kit. Don't just go with the basic stuff that you typically find inside the first aid kits. Make sure you actually put some stuff in there that you know is quality items. So you should already have this in your vehicle. You should also have something like this in your home as well. But if you don't, something you need to get on. Here's something that a lot of people leave out of their emergency kits, especially their first aid kits: gloves. If somebody's bleeding, you don't want to transfer germs onto their wound, and you don't want to get whatever type of germs they may have. So, good idea. Flashlights. You should already have flashlights in your bug out bag. You should already have that in your house. Plenty of them. Should even consider a lantern, a battery lantern. I consider other types of lanterns, oil lamps, but I just thought that a lot of that stuff is just too big of a fire hazard. You know, if somebody knocks it over, you know, that could be pretty bad. So I'm gonna go with the electric stuff. All right, so there you go. Those are some items that I think that everybody should have when they are leaving for an emergency. Again, it's not ideal. You don't wanna really leave your home and your resources, but if you gotta go, those are some top priority items. Thank you guys for watching. Thank you for listening. And if I missed something, please let me know. Don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today.